Welcome everyone! In today's video, we're going to explore the power of seamless integration using the Boomi-based PortaOne Workflows and discover how it can transform your business operations. I'm Sergii Kirik and I'll be your guide on this integration journey. First, we're going to delve into the two main interfaces of PortaBilling, events and API. Then we'll unlock the magic of Boomi's library of integration processes with the Getting Started with PortaBilling connectivity package. After that, we'll demonstrate the real-time integration of PortaBilling events and explore the flexibility of the PortaOne Workflows API capabilities. Finally, we'll summarize the key takeaways to help you kickstart your integration in the years. So without further ado, let's get started. Before you can master the integration process, it's important to first understand those two core interfaces of PortaBilling, events and API. Let's start with events. PortaBilling events allow you to capture real-time data changes, like the creation of a new customer, service activation, or a payment update. PortaBilling API, on the other hand, lets you perform various operations programmatically, such as fetching customer information, service specifications, or updating billing details. Now, here comes the exciting part. PortaOne Workflows has an incredible ability to both receive events from PortaBilling and to call the PortaBilling API. But how? Let's find the answer together in Boomi's integration library. The Boomi integration library is a treasure trove of pre-built integration packages that save you time and effort. Check out this gem, Getting Started with PortaBilling Connectivity. This package is your gateway to a seamless connection between PortaOne Workflows and PortaBilling. Even better, installing it is incredibly easy. With just a few clicks, you'll have access to the whole new world of integration possibilities. And the best part is the library offers a wide range of other available packages to explore. Now let's put our newly installed Getting Started with PortaBilling connectivity package to the test. I'm deploying the first part of the package, specifically the PortaBilling event parking process, to the runtime. Choose a demo environment, put some deployment notes, review, and deploy. Deployment successful. Now I need to configure interconnect credentials between PortaBilling Event Sender and our PortaBilling Event Parking process in PortaOne Workflows. For that, I go to our runtime, which is in the cloud. I verify that our process is deployed. We can see it as a listener as well. So let's go and interconnect that. I'll create a user to authorize PortaBilling Event Sender. Give it a username. Manage access to PortaBilling Event Parking Process Only, generate token and save. Yep. Now we can configure PortaBilling part. Let's go to our infrastructure, then event handlers, and create an event sender instance towards PortaOne Workflows. We choose type event sender and continue configuration, opening the object configuration. We choose API version 1 because we need extended events. And let's put credentials that we prepared. Let's put them to basic house user. The token that pet we put to house key. Let's take the base URL for API requests, in our case for events, to the event sender URL. But we also need to add an extra path which we take from the web server, operation. The path will allow us to route those events to that specific process, working process. In event subscriptions, we choose custom and new event. So we are subscribed to all new customers which we onboard to the PortaBilling. Yep. And finally, in PortaOne Workflows, we would also need to configure environment extensions to allow those PortaBilling events, otherwise they will be filtered. So we add our customer new event type and make sure that those events are from our environment. Number 5 in our case. Eventually, PortaBilling and PortaOne Workflows are already interlinked. Now let's see what happens when an event is triggered. For that, let's create a new customer in PortaBilling. That'd be myself, Sergii Kirik. Save. Look, a new customer has just been created in PortaBilling, and we can see its ID is 8149. And let's move to the Boomi Queue Management panel to make sure that our event is parked. We can find the event parking queue, and yeah, voila, the message is here. We'll just make sure that this message matches our event. But in the end, it's ready for seamless consumption by other integration application. And what happens next brings us to the second star of this automated magic show. That's API. Now let's explore the power of this tool's capabilities to call PortaBilling API. I'm going to deploy another piece of install library package, PortaBilling events consumer process. As we can see, we consumed it from the event parking event, check that the customer is new, and then get customer information, transform that to update the customer information. What we actually do in this example, we concatenate a customer ID and name and put that together into the name. It's just for example to demonstrate how we can update data using PortaBilling API as well as read it. All right, but before that, before deployment, let's prepare and configure API credentials to interconnect Workflows Runtime with PortaBilling API server. Will be organized, that's why we create connections folder and put a connection towards PortaBilling admin interface, RESTful interface into this folder. We're going to create one more folder to keep our certificates. We use certificates here to encrypt and decrypt the token to access PortaBilling. So let's create those PGP certificates. I typically suggest to call up the target system and then space, and then specifying is it private, public. For private certificate, let's generate it. The identity could be our target API server, just demoportaOne.com. To secure this private key, I can suggest you generating a password. For example, 32 characters long. Okay. Yeah. Once it's saved, I suggest you also export the public certificate, because we will need it in two occasions. First, we'll need to create another certificates in this folder, a public one, so we could explicitly use it to encrypt the token. So we can import it from our folder where we previously downloaded it. Just save it. The pair of PGP certificates is ready, and we can deploy this process to our runtime demo environment. This process will start immediately consume from the PortaBilling event parking queue. But it's not yet ready to do that because we didn't put any credentials to access PortaBilling service. So let's go and quickly pause this listener. Once listener is paused, let's configure credentials to access PortaBilling API service. We choose environment extensions and configure PortaBilling admin REST connections. Let's take the base URL, demoportone.com, and put it to URL. Also add a base path, REST. We also need to configure our previously created PGP certificates. So for private auth certificates, we choose a private one. And for public, we choose demoportone.com public one. Okay. And in PortaBilling auth cross-reference table, we also need to add credentials to access PortaBilling API with a certain access level. For that, in PortaBilling, we create a user. Let's say PortaOne-Workflows. We generate password. We put email of the person responsible for access management or owning PortaOne Workflows. In my case, it's my email. And we choose role. So once user is created, we can start filling this table. For application, we put wildcard, meaning that any application in PortaOne Workflows can use these credentials. For environment, we also use wildcard for simplicity. And for login, we put PortaOne-Workflows, just like we created. We create API token in PortaBilling, copy that, and we need to encrypt it using PGP tool. I'm using pgptool.org, which is using a library of your browser, so it's safe to use. This is our token, and we also need to use the public key to encrypt the token. Okay, click encrypt, and our encrypted PGP message, we use only part of that, copy that, and put back to our PortaBilling auth table. Of course, we need to save our user in PortaBilling. PortaOne Workflows is now interconnected with PortaBilling API server. It's good time to resume our listener. go to listeners, check PortaBilling event consumer, and resume. And we can now watch as PortaOne Workflows efficiently process the event and makes the API call to PortaBilling. If we click on this time, be able to see details about this execution. Particularly, we can show logs. We can even save them. And it takes time to more logs, more metadata to appear in the our platform from our runtime. So we check this out a little bit later and see more details here. We can clearly see HTTP client calls towards PortaBilling admin REST interface and get customer info calls as well as details about our event that we consumed in the very beginning of our execution. We can also browse the runtime queue management panel and make sure that our message was consumed and there is no dead letter, meaning there is no error in consuming our message, our event. Now we can see our customer. It used to be named Sergii Kirik, but now its name is prefixed with customer ID. And let's see audit logs. The first entry is about customer creation, that's what I did. And the second entry is PortaOne Workflows automatically updating name from Sergii Kirik to customer ID space Sergii Kirik, just like we had that in our PortaOne workflow process. So that was your entire start to finish process of accessing the amazing Boomi process library using one of the packages there to connect PortaOne workflows with PortaBilling. Let's quickly recap the essential lessons. First, PortaBilling offers two key interfaces, events and API. Next, that the Boomi library is a treasure trove of low-code and no-code integration packages that can help you make all of your processes seamless. And that includes a fantastic Getting Started with PortaBilling connectivity package. PortaOne Workflows enables real-time integration of PortaBilling events, keeping your systems in sync effortlessly. And finally, this tool's capabilities let you perform various operations with PortaBilling programmatically. Armed with all of this knowledge, you are now ready to streamline your business operations with PortaBilling, PortaOne Workflows, and the Boomi integration library. Thank you for joining us on this integration journey. If you have any questions about PortaOne Workflows or need further assistance, feel free to reach out to a team at PortaOne. And don't forget to explore the Boomi library for more incredible integration possibilities. Once you see all the possibilities that are available to you there, we encourage you to go ahead and start simplifying your business processes today. Remember to like, share, and subscribe for more valuable content. Until next time, stay connected and stay ahead. Cheers!